It's the culmination of state championship weekend. National Player of the Year Kyler Murray hopes to lead the Allen Eagles to a third straight state championship and undefeated season. They face Cy Ranch coming up next.
Back in the early 60s, I was a running back for North Little Rock High School. I went on to co-captain the 64 national champion Arkansas Razorbacks. And now I'm the owner and president and general manager of the five-time Super Bowl champion Dallas Cowboys. I'm Jerry Jones. It takes hard work, desire, and a passion to reach the championship game at any level. So I admire and respect the teams and the coaches who've earned their way to Texas high school football title games here at AT&T Stadium. There's a big future ahead for many of these young players and coaches. So congratulations and good luck. Another championship trophy will be awarded right now on Fox Sports Southwest.
The 10th and final state high school football championship game of Texas will be the final high school football game played in 2014, and it features the team with the longest winning streak going for a third consecutive state football crown. Live from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, Fox Sports Southwest and the UIL proudly present the Class 6A Division I State Football Championship featuring the Mustangs, a Cypress Ranch High School out of the greater Houston area, against the two-time defending state champion Allen Eagles, Glendale-Fort Worth Metroplex. Hi again, everybody. I'm Craig Way, pleased to be joined by Shea Walker. One game left out of 10 state championship contests. One game remaining to see if Allen can make it three in a row as Cy Ranch stands in their way, but the Eagles have been incredible.
Well, they really have, and they've been incredible ever since Kyler Murray showed up on campus as a young sophomore, leads his team to two back-to-back state championships in this incredible winning streak, and he has been dynamic throughout.
How has he done it? Kyler Murray not only has been the outstanding player on his team, the outstanding player certainly in high school football in the Dallas-Fort Worth area and across the state, but he's the national high school football player of the year, and look at that record as a starting quarterback.
Well, the accolades continue to pile up, and Craig, I tell you, he has certainly earned every one of them, because what he does offensively for the Eagles is give them the scoring punch that, regardless of where they are in the game, if they're trailing, which they have trailed, and certainly they've trailed through the playoffs, and he brings them back quickly, 2-3 play drives, he can go the length of the field, he's that dynamic.
It also helps when you have an outstanding target to throw the football to, and he does have that in Jalen Guyton.
But Jalen Guyton has been huge, and you talk about a security blanket, and most quarterbacks have one. Jalen Guyton is that guy. He is headed to Notre Dame, and he has just been phenomenal all year long. You see the yards per catch there and the touchdown, just the production out of Guyton. He is the go-to receiver.
Now, for all of the accolades, and richly deserved for the Allen Eagles, it's not like Cy Ranch's chopped liver. These Mustangs have come through a very tough greater Houston area, and Colin Rock has come through his own trials to emerge as the Mustangs quarterback and leader of this football team.
Yeah, I'm going to take that, the last one first, the leader part, and that is exceptional comment about him, because he is so critical to these guys, and he is a run guy, a throw guy, but you see, all he does is win. He's the Al Davis. He's a just win baby guy. He's got great blocking up front. He's got a big physical offensive line, a heavy running game. But Colin Rock is the leader of that team.
So it's Allen trying to make it 43 in a row and three consecutive state titles. Cy Ranch hoping to be in the way of that and to win their first kickoff coming up next.
For you, Sam.
Thanks, Craig. Coach, your third straight trip here. What are the emotions like going into this one?
Oh, it's a lot of fun. There's a lot of seniors that have put in a lot of hard work, and, you know, tonight is all about having a little bit of fun and see if we can send them out on top.
From what you know about Cy Ranch, what's the game plan and your message to these boys tonight?
Well, we've got to play good defense. They run the football really well, and then what we got to do offensively is cut Kyler loose and have some fun.
Looking forward to it, Coach. Appreciate it. Best of luck. Let's get it over to Brooke with Gene Johnson.
Coach, your program's first trip to the state title game. You're playing the top team in Texas on the biggest stage in Texas. What was your message to the team?
Well, we just got to try to treat it like another football game. They're not top team in Texas, though. They're top, one of the top in the nation. So we got a tremendous challenge, but what a neat atmosphere for our kids to be able to come and play in this.
How does your defense contain quarterback Kyler Murray?
Well, we're going to let the air out of the ball, and every time he starts moving it too much, we're going to run out there and grab it and throw it back on the sidelines. I don't know. We got to try to keep everything in front of us and try to do the best we can to be good tacklers, but we got a tremendous challenge ahead of us.
Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
Greg, back to you.
Brooke Bentley, thank you very much. Brooke will be on the Cyrant sideline this evening. Aaron Hartigan on the Allen Eagle sideline.
Hey, Greg, I want to say, watching these Cyrant Mustangs go through warm-ups, it doesn't look like the stage is too big for them. They feel very comfortable. They look really relaxed. Let's see if that translates into game time.
R.J. Montanoli will kick off for the Mustangs. And Taylor Whistler, one of the Allen Eagle back, but back deep to receive it, Jalen Guyton. So one high school game left in 2014. And here we go from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, where they open the upper deck tonight to accommodate this huge crowd. It'll be fielded at the 2-yard line by Jalen Jones. Jones still trying to dance his way around traffic. On his feet out to the 35-yard line. Eagles won the toss and wanted to go right to work offensively. A 34-yard return. And Kyler Murray, the senior quarterback, has thrown for nearly 4,400 yards this season and 49 touchdowns, completing 64% of his passes.
And almost a mirror image, Craig, of the season that he had last year leading the Eagles to a state championship. And you go back to the year prior as a sophomore, kind of grew up a little bit in that season, but still, outstanding job.
Over 1,400 rushing yards as well. He'll throw, however, on the first scrimmage play of the game, going deep, incomplete, as he was looking for Jalen Guyton. Officials ruling that the pass was overthrown. Nico Johnson had the coverage. Take another look at it here.
Well, I think this is a good no call. Jalen Guyton, though, opening up the game, and you can see using the nice post route. Just he and Nico Johnson's feet get hooked up. You can see Johnson's hands were not anywhere near Guyton.
Murray, quick pass out. And across the 45 to the 45-yard line, a 9-yard catch and run to Lee Morris, the wide receivers. You look at the Ford starting lineup for the Eagles. Gregory Little, Jason Stoughton, Cody Wheeler, Brian Cornell, William Sherman up front. The backs and receivers, Keon Williams, Jalen Guyton, of course. Gary Hall, Lee Morris out there. And a run by Keon Williams and a first down for Allen.
We talk about it in the open, but just fast play, quick pace, and that's what this Allen Eagle offense does.
Murray to throw. Again, looking for the deep shot. Downfield and caught. Touchdown. Cody Butler, his sixth touchdown catch of the season.
Greg, we saw the post route by Jalen Guyton on the right side of the offense. They come back a couple of plays later with Cody Butler running the exact same play, but from the left side. Kyler Murray drops the ball in there perfectly, drops it right over the top of the defender. We saw Cody Butler just reach those hands out at the very last second. Great catch going into the end zone.
Sawyer Williams with the extra point. Allen strikes first. Jay, you brought it up. The Eagles in the postseason have had to rally to win some games. They're trying to not even worry about that as they strike 52 seconds into the game. The 2014 UIL 6A State High School Football Championship on Fox Sports Southwest is brought to you by State Farm. Visit texas.statefarm.com to get to a better state. By Ford. The Dream Big Sales event is going on right now at your Texas Ford dealer. Ford is the best in Texas. And by DQ, the stop sign for Texas. For the best treats, eats, and drinks in Texas, stop at DQ. Didn't take very long for the Eagles to capitalize. Initial drive for Allen. And the Eagles strike on a 51-yard touchdown pass from Kyler Murray to Cody Butler to cap the opening march of 64 yards and four plays, and it takes all of 52 seconds for the defending state champions to take the early lead.
Well, the offensive-minded Tom Westberg knowing that you've got Kyler Murray and explosive receivers elected to take the ball on offense first, and that's generally not what those guys do.
Mark Bruno, kickoff return, he'll bring it out to the 19-yard line, and that's where Cy Ranch will go on the attack. You mentioned Colin Rock and the numbers that he has put up, this junior quarterback, and G. Johnson said, you know, he emerged as the season went on, not only as a leader, but the guy who was the most consistent delivered for the Mustangs. And, of course, he has an outstanding running back in his senior Charlie Booker, who's rushed for nearly 1,400 yards this season. Booker is in the backfield. The deep back in the eye, and it is Booker who draws the carry on first down.
And this is a very physical offensive front for the Mustangs.
Looking at the forward starting lineup on offense for Cy Ranch. You have Zach Kinniger, Gabe Swift, Chris Lane, Logan Desharm, and Keaton Thorne, the offensive front. Dylan Prosky, Charlie Booker, Cameron Greer, Cullen Motzinger, and Dwight Benn are the receivers tied in. And it's second down and five from the 24. Booker, again, good running work and a first down. Charlie Booker picks up five more. As we look at the Allen Eagle defense, the forward starting lineup for the two-time defending state champions on defense for Allen. Sione Chupo, Ryan Hemman, Brett Burleson, Levi Wazirike, Dallas George, BC Tupu, and Jacob Yandel, the linebackers. And in the secondary, it's Anthony Taylor, Jalen Ellis, Jalen Jones, and Michael Newsom. Two carries by Charlie Booker, the first down for Cy Ranch from the Mustang 29. Keeping Rock. Serves forward, then was driven back. Cy Ranch pretty confident that they can move the football on this Allen defense, which, as Tom Westenberg has said, has been pretty young and learning this season, and they've yielded some yards, a lot of yards and some points.
Well, they have, Craig, and you think about what they lost off of last year's team, Tay Evans, who went to Oklahoma, Christian Sam and Chad Adams, both outstanding linebackers, are at Arizona State. And Naomi Olutu is at Northern Illinois. A lot of talent has left this Allen Eagle program from last year.
Second and seven, Charlie Booker again. Big running run for Booker on a first down near the midfield stripe. The senior running back, Booker, Jalen Jones, the tackle for the Eagles.
Nice job of cutting back, Booker. Great vision, and that's outstanding blocking. Gabe Swift doing a fantastic job of walling off the defender. There's a big run right there by Booker.
First down and 10 for Cy Ranch. It's a 17-yard run for Charlie Booker.
And this is what Gene Johnson means when he said to Brooke Bentley that we're going to take the air out of the ball. That's exactly what he means, is that a long, sustaining drive and trying to keep that Allen offense in check.
On first down, it's Booker yet again across midfield and into Allen territory. Walk down on Wazirike. But a gain of 4 yards, and it's second down at six. And you mentioned that big offensive front for Cy Ranch are getting a very good push up front.
Well, and you go through the playoff run for these guys. The last three games, North Shore was a game they won by 4 points, Dickinson by three, and then Converse Judson in the semifinals won that game by seven. That offensive line, that offensive front has seen some aggressive defenses, and so far they've come out on the top side of it.
Second down and six. And again, the carry by Booker. Wazirike, the tackle. Third down and three coming up. Cy Ranch getting to Arlington for some pretty impressive wins, beating the perennial power North Shore, ending Dickinson's unbeaten year, and then, of course, beating Commerce Judson in the Alamo Dome.
Well, and that win against Cinco Ranch, that kind of avenged an early season loss that the Mustangs suffered. So got that done and took care of that in around the playoffs. So ball on the ground.
Third down and three, and on the exchange, the ball is loose, and the Eagles recover. Allen will take over. Sione Tupou with the recovery, and the Eagles have it.
Watch the exchange. Yep, right, the exchange right there as Rock was pulling the ball back. Booker had already flashed to the left. And as he's pulling the ball back down, loses the handle. And Tupou, getting good pressure and good penetration, falls on the ball. That's a huge turnover. And I'm going to call it a short field for the Allen Eagles offense.
Absolutely. Ball is at the Eagle 49. Certainly short enough for Murray. This is one of the things Kyler Murray can do. And turn it upfield, get to the edge when it looks like he's trapped, and turn what seems to be a loss into positive yards and a big gain, and in this case, 9 yards.
Had a defender setting the edge, brought the pressure up the middle. Kyler Murray is still elusive enough and fast enough to get back out around that and turn that into a positive play.
Second of the yard for Allen. Cy Ranch 42. Quick pass to Guyton. He'll have the first down. Inside the 35. Look at the Cy Ranch Mustang defense with a forward starting lineup for Gene Johnson's team. Across the front, three down linemen, Trent Walker, Justin Rabelais, Jackson Solbeck, the linebackers, Miles Roll, Braden Stringer, Christian Cobal, and Ahmad Willis-Dayton in the secondary, Nico Johnson. And you see right now, a scrambling Kyler Murray running yet again. Murray cutting across the field. And that's one of the more exciting 4-yard runs you'll ever see.
Well, it's a 4-yard gain, and it's about a 70-yard run. Take another look. Good pressure by the Mustangs defense, forcing Murray to bounce it out wide. Once he does, defensive lineman not going to catch him in space, but as he cut back across the middle, as you said, Craig, picks up about 4 yards, but that's after running about 65, 70.
Second down at 6. Murray across the middle and incomplete, trying to hook up at Guyton. He's matched up with Kenzie Lopez, the corner, and they're going right at Lopez. So it's third down at 6 for the Eagles. Out of the shotgun. Glance to the sideline for the play call. To the air one more time for Kyler Murray. Going deep. Has a man, but beyond the reach of Guyton. And it's fourth down for Allen.
Well, Bryce Orsini did a nice job of staying in front of Guyton and really affected the throw from Kyler Murray, and the Mustangs brought a little bit of pressure there, dialing up a blitz from one of the safeties coming down, and that's where it left the middle of the field open, where he was trying to find Guyton, but Sarcini there to make sure that Guyton was nowhere near catching that ball.
Now for the field goal try, Sawyer Williams, who's hit 7 field goals this season. This one a 46-yarder, but it will stay left. That is no good. So Cy Ranch dodges the bullet after the turnover, and the Mustangs will get the football back. Tom Westerberg thought maybe they might be able to already extend it to a double-digit lead. It's still only 7-0, Allen. And now a special message from State Farm.
I'm John.
State championship trophies have been presented. Class 2A Division 1 and 2, 3A D1 and D2, 4A D1 and D2, 5A D2 last night, 5A D1 today at noon, and of course the 6A Division 2 state championship just a little while ago with Cedar Hill defeating Katy. Now the one remaining game, 6A Division 1, largest classification in the state of Texas. Allen, the 2-time defending state champion, with a 7-0 lead, but Cy Ranch holding on defense, and the Mustangs go back to work. And one thing, Shea, you can say Charlie Booker already 34 yards on 7 carries, so some good
impressive running.
5 carries, so some good carries so far. Now out of an empty set, Rock will take off and run. Allen Rock still on his feet. Across the 40 and up to the 43-yard line is Colin Rock for a first down. Dalton Battle, the inside linebacker on the tackle. First down, a pickup of 14 yards.
Yeah, the right side of the offensive line did a great job there, as you said, Craig. Empty backfield that spread the Allen Eagle defense out, and that big offensive lineman just pushed and caved everything in toward the middle of the field. Colin Rock goes right behind him for that game.
Cyrance from its own 43. Well, back to the ground this time to Chandler Thomas, the running back.
But I see any topo on that tackle right there. He's staying at home and keeping leverage, and they tried to run the little inside handoff going back against the grain, and number five stayed home. Comes up on the tackle. Nice job.
Tupou was ready for that. Now it's second down after a loss of 2 yards back to the 41. Rock drifts back into the shotgun. Calling a play, looking to throw over the middle. A catch and a first down to the tight end, Jackson Solbeck. 17 yards and a first down for the Mustangs.
Well, and a nice target too, 6'3", 235 pounds. And Colin Rock recognized the defense was coming off the edge with pressure. He gets the ball out quickly, and Solbeck comes up with the catch.
You'd have to think that Gene Johnson likes what he's seen out of his offense. They've been able to move the football here in the first quarter. First and 10 at the Allen 43. Back to the ground to Booker. Gain of 3 yards to the 40-yard line. Brings up second down and seven. Uzurike and Brett Burleson on the team up tackle for the Eagles. Iran's trying to play that methodical style, take their time, make sure of the play call. With Booker in the backfield, it's Charlie Booker. Second down, bouncing it outside, and still on his feet is Booker.
What a run by Booker, and the fact that he stayed in bounds, taking the shots like a pinball, as many as he did. Great balance. Should be enough for, it is enough for the first down.
Yeah, Misi Tupou finally brought it down, but not before Booker reached the line to gain. And a first and 10 at the 31-yard line of the Eagles. Cyrance on the move on its second possession. Eagles were moving the ball in the first possession before the fumble. Now back to the ground. And a gain of a couple for Chandler Thomas. Getting up to the bottom of the pile, Levi Uzurike. I have a feeling we'll call his name a few times tonight. I already have called it a few times.
Well, 223-pound junior defensive end. We called his other battery mate, the bookend, Sione Tupou, a couple of times as well. Those defensive linemen active for the Allen Eagles, and they're going to have to be active to try to slow down this run game from Cy Ranch.
At the Allen 29, it's second down and 8. Again, Colin Rock, the keeper. Second time on this drive he's done it. Rock inside the 25, down to the 24. A pickup of 5 yards. And Dallas George, the outside linebacker for the Eagles, makes the stop.
And you like the patience of Rock. It's not like he's trying to bust it out wide and make a big play. He's going to get the yards that are available to him and push it down as far as he can. And trying to get into third and short, and he was able to do that now. Third and about 3 to go.
At the Eagle 24. Booker is the deep back. And it is Booker who draws the carry. Booker the corner. Booker stepped out of bounds just prior to the 5-yard line. He'll be marked out at the 7. It'll be first and goal, Cy Ranch.
Well, after he broke the line of scrimmage, Craig, he got an outstanding block from his wide receiver. Take another look as he bounces it out to the left side here. That block right there. And Booker steps out around the 4-yard line.
That block was Chandler Thomas with a big block, a forward block. And now it's first and goal. Cy Ranch at the Allen 7-yard line. Charlie Booker lined up right beside Colin Rock. It's Booker. Surge forward, I believe, to a five, certainly as far as the six-yard line. Ryan Hyman, the defensive tackle, wasn't going to let it be anything more than that as Hyman brings it in. 1 yard pick up to the six, and it's second down and goal.
You said this earlier about in this drive, but exactly what Gene Johnson wants to do is the methodical drive, as you said, with the running game and just kind of the pounding and the punishing running game and picking up first downs. And really, you see it taking effect right now because this offensive line is getting a very good push.
Second and goal, Cy Ranch at the Allen Eagle six. And it's Rock keeping ahead down to the 4 yard line. EC Tupo, the tackle, and it's third and goal. Actually, put it down at the five. Call it third and goal, Cy Ranch at the Allen five.
Well, that Eagle defense stood tall on that play. Owuzurike lost his helmet, but he got down in the middle and just kind of bogged everything down for Cy Ranch. And had it not been for Colin Rock spinning around to his right side, wouldn't have gotten the ball down as far as he did, but still a little bit of real estate to go. Ball on the 5 yard line.
Third and goal for the Mustangs. Trying to match the Allen first quarter touchdown. Rock with a flag down. The pass was caught, but play was stopped before it ever got going. And the touchdown catch to RJ Sneed will not stand.
Before the snap, offsides, out on number 76. Covers half the distance, remains third down.
There's the encroachment making contact.
Yep, and that killed the play, Billy, and the whistle was blown clearly, so not a free play, but RJ Steve keeping the play alive, still does a nice job going out there and grabbing it, all to no avail. Now it's going to be third down, but half the distance to the goal.
So it's third and goal now from the two. Straight ahead, Booker pushing forward. Charlie Booker to the end zone. Touchdown, Cy Ranch.
EC Tupo, the linebacker, hits Booker first, and he is well short. Is right around the line of scrimmage, but Craig, the extra effort by Booker. And he took a shot from the middle linebacker. Was able to absorb that blow in the pile and look at the surge going in, getting into the end zone.
That was the most impressive thing, is that offensive line refused to give up. Extra point kick by Blake Lieberman is good. Impressive drive for Charlie Booker, who scored the touchdown, and for Cy Ranch. And look at the pile moving forward again here, Jay.
He gets popped right at the 2 yard line, line of scrimmage, and then it looks like the Allen Eagles are going to be able to withhold Booker from getting into the end zone. And then it's just the white jersey. Looks like a tug of war. White jerseys win on that one, and they push the pile into the end zone.
Well, the rugby scrum carries into the end zone. And Cy Ranch has tied the score at 7 here with 12 seconds to go in the first quarter. This is how Gene Johnson drew it up. Limit possessions, as he said, take the air out of the ball. Methodical drives. Stay even with the Eagles, if not ahead. Give yourself a chance to win.
Well, you know, he said that, as have 41 other teams.
True.
I mean, everybody knows what to do and just the how to do it, or the execution of how to do it to get it done. But a very effective drive. That's 6 minutes, 10 seconds off the clock and 11 plays. Impressive drive.
Consider that. It's a scoring drive that eclipses more than half a quarter.
Yep.
That's what limiting possessions is all about.
And now the Eagles. They've had, what, two possessions?
Yep. Touchdown. And, of course, the missed field goal.
Missed field goal, right.
And that included getting the football to start the game. The second possession came as a result of a Cy Ranch turnover when the Mustangs were moving the football. So a kickoff today. By Dominic White. By pop-up kick. And then coming up the sidelines, forced out of bounds, was Kerry Hall. Allen's third possession coming up here, and only 7 seconds to go in quarter number one. Now it's up to the Cy Ranch defense to see if they can figure out a way to keep Allen from moving the ball effectively. The Eagles, even though they missed the field goal last drive, were able to move the ball.
They did move the ball, and really Kyler Murray, the difference in that last drive, even though it didn't deliver points, but the Mustang defenders were in the right spots, but they still couldn't corral Kyler Murray.
From the Eagle 31, David Feliciano, junior running back, carries on the final play of the first quarter. Well, this game started with the two-time defending champs looking every bit the part on the scoring strike to open the ball game. But Cy Ranch with a methodical drive to tie it at the end of the first quarter of a 6A Division I championship.
Another call.
Second quarter ready to begin of the Class 6A Division I state championship. Greg Way, Shea Walker, Brooke Bentley, Aaron Hardigan, and our Fox Sports Southwest High School State Championship telecast team from here at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. And you look at the first quarter, that time of possession is exactly what Cy Ranch wants it to be in this game.
Yes, it is. And, you know, the number of plays as well, 18 to 10, and chewing up the clock as often as they can.
Allen, second down and 8. Pitch out to Kerry Hall back inside, but it only works for a couple. Call it a 3-yard gain, maybe 4, to the 37-yard line. It'll be 3rd down and 4 for the Eagles. Feliciano is the running back. All set to the left of Kyler Murray. Murray, the time to throw, and a catch made at midfield.
Craig, you see the arm strength right there by Kyler Murray. He had a sideline route that was beyond the chains. However, he only had 2 guys rushing. They dropped 9 into defense, and you see him throw the ball in just that incredibly tight window where his wide receiver comes up with it on the sideline for the first down.
It was Jalen Guyton. It's a first down at the 50-yard line for Allen, and right back to the air again to Guyton. Guyton with a gain of 6 more. Now to the Cy Ranch 44-yard line as finally he was forced down by Kenzie Lopez. Allen likes to go quick tempo with his 2nd down and 4 to the ground. And Keon Williams on the carry. It's a big hit going on, but Williams close to a 1st down. Christian Cobalt, the tackle, but it's enough to move the chains, and Allen with another 1st down. The Eagles do like to score quickly. Who wouldn't? And they do a lot of that. Here's Murray. Gonna take off this time. Cy Ranch defense collapses pretty quickly as Miles Rowland, great stringer on the tackle. But Shea, one thing that they can do, they can be methodical at times and matriculate the ball down the field with a short passing game.
And it's really just a very comfortable thing for Kyler Murray because he's been doing this now since his sophomore year and feels very confident in their ability to convert on 3rd downs. And this was a really nice run by Keon Williams.
Yeah, it was. Looked like he was stood up, still bounced it outside. Finally was brought down after he ran right to the middle of a pile and then turned it outside before Ahmad Willis-Dalton could make the tackle. 3rd down and 4 from the 34. Williams the running back and 4 wide receivers for the Eagles. Murray quickly and quick response. The ball caught by Cody Butler and coming over to stand him up, Kenzie Lopez, and it's 4th down.
Well, Lopez did a very nice job of reacting very quickly, so he gets in front of the would-be block from Lee Morris and is able to bring Cody Butler down for a negative play.
A gain of only 1 yard It's fourth down and four at the 34. For Allen, a one-yard gain is a negative play, Shane. They expect to get a lot more than
that. Yes, they do. And just such an outstanding play coming up by Kenzie Lopez. It felt like a negative play.
Well, the Eagles are going to go for it.
Yeah, they're kind of in the no-go zone. Too long to kick a field goal, really not wanting to risk the punt. And
they'll go for it here. Fourth down and four. The quick pass, the catch, and a first down. Kerry Hall. Man, that is precision work by Kyler Murray. It goes for 9 yards and a first down.
He gets the ball out so quickly in the tight ball right where his wide receiver catches it, and all he needs to do is move forward, fall forward to pick up the first down.
At the 25. Over the middle and intercepted and dropped. Right in and then out of the hands of Bryce Sarcini. As Sarcini had a chance and just couldn't hold it.
Well, not sure about that particular pass, but Sarcini read it perfectly, steps in front of Guyton. Not able to hang on, though, and the Allen Eagles maintain possession.
Second and 10 at the 25. Good pass again, and then cutting inside the 20, and near another first down is Kerry Hall. It's a gain of 9.
Well, it's just finding the hot hand right now and distributing the ball out. And you see this Allen Eagle offensive coordinator Jeff Fleener, very comfortable in getting the ball out quickly to the wide receivers and just letting those guys make moves downfield.
Murray will keep it himself on third and one, and he has it. Took a pop, but he'll pick up 3 yards and a first down for Allen at the Cy Ranch 13.
And Juan Perez was there, but Kyler Murray makes that move, and luckily turns his back and falls forward to make sure that he picks up enough yards for the first down.
Allen first down at the Cy Ranch 13-yard line. Murray looking to throw again to the end zone. Guyton couldn't hold it.
Well, good coverage there by Kenzie Lopez right in front of Jalen Guyton. Take another look at the top of the screen. Guyton flashes inside, goes back to the outside. Ball's in his hands, but gets disrupted at the very end by Kenzie Lopez. Great job, cornerback hanging in, making the play late.
Second and 10 from the 13. On a rollout this time for Murray. Sliding catch made at the 5-yard line by Kerry Hall. Boy, he does the dirty work, doesn't he? Just gets into space and finds a little seam to catch and keep the drive going.
Well, that inside receiver, he's got 59 catches for 600 yards coming into the game, and goes down and he digs that one out, comes up with the grab.
Third and 2 at the 5 to Keon Williams. Williams to the goal line and a little bit short, but it will be first and goal for Allen.
Well, that was an impressive run by Keon Williams. Knew that he was going to take a shot, lowered the shoulders, and now Allen going quickly.
First and goal. Williams vaulting over the top to put Allen back on top. Keon Williams, his 7th rushing touchdown of the season. Allen back in front.
Well, that's a pedestrian drive by Allen's standards. But I think from a confidence standpoint, Craig, that was really a good drive. Executed when they needed to, converted on third downs, made the plays that they needed to make, getting in the end zone for a score.
Deion Williams airborne to put Allen back up. High School 6A Division I Football Championship on Fox Sports Southwest is brought to you by State Farm. Visit texas.statefarm.com to get to a better state. By Ford, the Dream Big Sales event is going on now at your Texas Ford dealer. Ford is the best in Texas. And by DQ, the stop sign for Texas. For the best treats, eats, and drinks in Texas, stop at DQ. The order has gone out. Jay Walker wants a Hunger Buster. Cy Ranch wants a touchdown to even this game as Allen has gone back in front 14-7.
Again, a very methodical drive. We're using that word a lot right now because the Allen Eagles decided, instead of using the punishing ground game that the Cy Ranch Mustangs use, they use the quick, short passing game to move the ball down the field, and did that in nice order, and they go up 14-7.
Here's the kickoff. And right at the goal line, it's Mark Bruno. Bruno takes and pops before he goes down to the 14-yard line. Take a look at their State Farm stat here of the first half to this point. And well, you see what they've done a lot on the ground. And the one pass went for a first down, Jay.
Oh, Jason Jackson, excuse me, Solbeck, tight end. Just a big target there. And after you get that run game pounding on you, grinding on you, tight end slips out, picked up that first down, and continued to drive as they went on to score their first touchdown. But the 17 rushes, that's exactly the recipe that they want to continue to employ. Let's see if they can get back and tie this game up.
Well, on play action now, Rock throwback going to Chandler Thomas. And after shaking the first man, here goes Thomas up the sideline. Chandler Thomas with the last man a chance to get him to create enough traffic. Jalen Ellis kind of using a bowling 7-10 split tactic to slide into him and limit the gain to only 62 yards.
Well, a very slow developing play, and I tell you what makes that play is that Colin Rock gets such incredible depth as he fakes the handoff first to his left side and rolls back around, and he was gaining or giving ground, if you will, and that allowed Chandler Thomas to slip back out to the left. Ball was thrown beautifully, and Thomas had to rest with his feet.
Back to the ground, and now it's Booker. Early Booker, pick up. Up four to the 20-yard line. Jacob Yandell, the tackle for the Eagles. Undaunted, Cy Ranch coming right back at Allen. Second down and six from the Eagle 20-yard line. Johnson's team had a long drive to tie it at the end of the first quarter. Moving a little quicker now down the field in an effort to tie the score second time. Booker, trouble this time, and down he goes. Excellent play by Yandell, the linebacker. Let's go down to the Cy Ranch sideline and check in with Brooke Bentley.
Thanks, Craig. Well, for many of the Cy Ranch players, this is their first time to AT&T Stadium. Not Charlie Booker. He's been coming here with his dad to the state championship games, and he told me he sat in the stands last year dreaming of playing on this field, and he can't believe his dreams have come true. By the way, Booker is going to Harvard next year to play football. So, guys, a pretty smart player we have on our hands. Craig, back to you.
All right. Thank you very much, Brooke. A Harvard man.
Well, and coming here and having the vision to dream about playing, that's fantastic. Great story, Brooke.
Third down and nine. Pass dumped to Booker. Turn in the corner. Charlie Booker. Up first down. It'll be first and goal. Finally forced out of bounds. Booker picks up 16 yards. Michael Newsom for the moment, preventing a touchdown.
Okay, going third and nine. And how about the play by Booker, the patience? First of all, Colin Rock doing a great job of drawing the defense in, waiting to the very last second to deliver down, and Booker does the rest. That was a fantastic play call.
At the Allen Eagle 7. Just past the midway mark of the second quarter. And this time it's Rock straight ahead. Only for a yard to the 6. BC Tupo, the tackle for the Eagles. Another look at Booker gaining the corner.
Well, the play was set up beautifully. Again, the patience, and then Colin Rock very comfortable with hanging back before he delivered it out there. And third and nine, it was a big conversion. Tupo becoming very active out of that linebacker spot for these Allen Eagles.
Rock stopped half the line of scrimmage, so it's second and goal from the Eagles 7. Rock to the air and behind the intended target, Cameron Greer, running the slant into the end zone, but it went behind him, and now it's third and goal. Greer with 9 touchdown catches this season. That's the first incompletion for Colin Rock tonight. Hadn't thrown the ball much, but when he has, he's been on the mark. That one a little bit behind Greer, however. Now third and goal. Third and goal. Booker in the backfield. Rock under center. Movement in the line, and that should give Cyranch a little more life. That's the second time there's been trouble in that Allen defensive front, as Will Udo was guessing the snap.
Offside. Allen number 76. Kobe's half the distance. Remains third down.
Wayne Elliott, the referee of this Austin chapter, one of the finest high school football officials in the state. Outstanding crew from this greater Austin chapter officiating this state championship game.
So the half the distance moves the ball all the way down to the 3-yard line. Still third down, however. Cy Ranch, we're maybe thinking about having to throw the ball to get it into the end zone. May want to reconsider now and see if they use the power run game.
The ball just shy of the Allen Eagle 3 on third and goal. Booker trying to surge forward. There goes that offensive line. It worked again. Pushing this time. Stopped short of the goal line. The ball popped out afterwards.
Only gained a yard, and this time the blue jerseys win the tug of war. Denying Charlie Booker the end zone. Gets hit there early, and that's BC Tupo again coming up from that linebacker spot.
Also Jacob Yandell. Fourth and goal, and no sign that Cy Ranch is interested in kicking a field goal. They'll go for it. Fourth and goal for the Allen Eagle 2. And a straight T look with 3 men over the backfield. Outside, bouncing forward. Ball came loose at the goal line. And Allen comes away with a stop and the turnover. Chandler Thomas stopped by Tyler Fleming, who comes away with a football, and it'll go over to the Eagles.
Well, the hand in the inside handoff went over to the right side. And then it looks as Chandler Thomas is leaning back and going in toward the end zone. It gets stripped out early. Looks like Dallas George, I believe, might have gotten a hand on it.
And then watch it hit the heel of one of the Eagles. Right there, popped up. Right into the waiting arms.
That was Dallas George on the strip, and what a nice job defensively by the Allen Eagles. And you got to believe it doesn't matter if you're 50 yards away or 100 or 99 or 98 like this particular possession. Doesn't really bother the Allen Eagles.
No, glad to have the football back as Cy Ranch comes away empty-handed from his own end zone. Murray airmails it. Try to go out for Jalen Guyton. Too much on it. And second down and 10 for the Eagle 2. You know, the momentum was carrying Chandler Thomas into the end zone, but couldn't bring the football along for the ride.
Well, the strip by Dallas George, that was fantastic. Just great aggressive defensive play down the goal line.
That's how far back the Eagles are now. And another deep ball, and again, too much on it. This one going out of bounds. Cody Butler had the coverage incomplete. Or Cody Butler, the intended receiver, and Kenzie Lopez the coverage. Incomplete, and now it's third down and 10 from the 2. Pass was thrown well out of bounds, uncatchable ball, and so that's why it's third down and 10.
But Jalen Guyton going out on the left side of the top side of the screen. He's the inside receiver splitting the other two guys.
Keon Williams in the backfield with Murray to block. Murray with a lot of time and going deep again and again. Too much on the ball. Guyton had a step on the defense. If the pass had been on the mark, it would have been a 98-yard touchdown. Instead, 3 incompletions, and Allen must punt from deep in its end zone on 4th and 10.
Well, Guyton doing a nice job of using leverage up the field and then breaking it back in towards the middle. He gets back behind the safety, and the ball just beyond his reach.
See the hit right there on Kyler Murray as he released the football from Mark Bruno, the safety, coming in. And Kalen Herod to punt. Cameron Greer, Motzinger back deep to receive it. That kick wobbles off the side, but it does take a good bounce and then skips out of bounds. It's still going to be excellent field position for Cy Ranch at the Eagle 35. So another opportunity for Cy Ranch late in the first half with Allen leading the 6A Division I state championship. Allen with the lead 14-7 on Cy Ranch. But the Mustangs have hung around, and Shea Walker bucked for turnovers. They might even have a lead or at least tie.
Well, you see on that first drive when they were having so much productivity, this exchange there between Colin Rock and Charlie Booker, and then going into the end zone, Chandler Thomas gets stripped. And that's a great defensive play there on the strip. However, Thomas does not go in, and the Mustangs do not get the score, and that's why they're trailing 14-7.
Mentioned how Allen has been in this situation many, many times this season. He said, wait a minute, they've won, you know, 42 in a row. How can that be? But some of the games they've had some wild shootouts. They had to come from behind to win the number one versus number two matchup against DeSoto, 25-22. They were down to Arlington Martin, came back and won going away. Beat Euless Trinity on a field goal, final play of the game, and then turned it on late in the ball game to pull away from Skyline High in bounds. First down, Booker on the carry, and Allen ready for it. Brett Burleson and Levi Aguzarike and on the tackle. Only a 1 yard pickup, and it's second down and 9.
We heard the hit on that up here in our booth. Brett Burleson, senior defensive lineman, doing a nice job of squaring up on Booker.
14 carries, 71 yards for Charlie Booker in this first half. Second down. He's trying to squirt through the middle is Booker. Jalen Jones filled the void, held it to a 4 yard gain down to the 30 yard line, where it's third down and 5 for Cy Ranch. So on third and 5, Cy Ranch with all three of its timeouts, but certainly Gene Johnson content to let this clock run down, realizing if they pick up a first down, they worry about using the timeouts later. From the 30, Colin Rock on a keeper. And Rock surging forward and would appear to have enough for the first down. Let's see where the spot is.
Greg, it looked like he might have had an opportunity to bounce that outside, but again, like we said earlier in the drive, he's not going to do anything fancy on third down. He knows the yardage that he needs to get, and he does get that yardage, that first down yardage. I like the decision making right there.
Yep, picks up enough to move it down to the Eagle 25. Now we watch the clock inside of 2 minutes remaining in the half. Again to the ground. And a short gain this time for Joseph Johnson, senior running back. Gain of 2 to the 23 and down to 90 seconds and counting here in the first half. Again, Cy Ranch with all three of its timeouts remaining. On second and 8. Rock will hand it. That's sweeping around the corner, Chandler Thomas, but he goes down at the line of scrimmage.
Tackle, Jalen Ellis. Great job in the open field. And Chandler looked like he had a little bit of room out there and was trying to outflank the secondary. Jalen Ellis comes up with a huge tackle.
Inside a minute to go in the half, and it's third down and 7. Rocking the shotgun. And the throw now. Looking deep. Into the end zone. And cannot connect with R.J. Sneed. And with 38 seconds to go, it's fourth down. Anthony Taylor, the coverage for Allen. One thing that Gene Johnson wanted to make sure to do, Shea, is to leave Allen as little time as possible on each possession.
Well, you did that here. And there was nothing going on in this play other than R.J. Sneed running the corner route, defended very well there by Anthony Taylor.
A field goal try for Cy Ranch to come from Dominic White, sophomore. 39-yard try for White, and it's good. Cy Ranch pulls a little closer, and only 33 seconds remaining in the first half. Dominic White knocking that through to pull the Mustangs to within four. As we draw near the end of the first half, which would mean the Ford Halftime Show is coming up with Rick Renner, Greg Tepper, Kent Purcell, the sixth state championship won by the Aledo Bearcats in exhilarating fashion. High wire act in the first game today. What a comeback for Cedar Hill against Katy. In what my broadcast partner on High School Scoreboard Live, Rick Renner, likes to refer to as the three match. The rubber match, which, by the way, Rick and I, for the last time this season, will host High School Scoreboard Live tonight following the game right there.
So you say, stay tuned.
Yeah, after the game tonight, I'll scurry up there and sit down with Rick. Dr. Charles Brightup, the executive director of the UIL, will join us up there. We'll talk about some of the great things that happened this weekend and some of the issues that have popped out of it as well. That's all coming up tonight on a state championship season finale edition of High School Scoreboard Live following the game tonight.
Well, we've said this many times, Craig, but you think about the effort and the army of people behind the scenes from the UIL that helped get this event off. I mean, and they've just really done a fantastic job again this year, and hats off to those guys.
Well, and looking around this stadium, like we said, 46,000 for the Cedar Hill Katy game. They have opened the upper deck here. A lot of fans have made their way into the highest levels of AT&T Stadium in Arlington. It's going to be interesting to see what the attendance will be. A fair catch called for and made. That one by Kerry Hall. So Allen does have 33 seconds. Now, another thing that Gene Johnson told us the other day when I talked about limiting possessions to him, he said, yeah, that's all fine and well, except Allen doesn't need much time to score.
They do not. And think about the deficits that they've overcome. I mean, just they were trailing by 18 against Dallas Skyline in the fourth quarter, and they ended up winning by 18.
They scored 35 points in the game's final 14 minutes, going from late third all the way to the end of the ball game, and went going away. So they don't need much time, and here goes Kyler Murray. Murray will step out of bounds, a short game. Clock down with 28 seconds to go in the half. Murray will take a quick look. If he doesn't see anybody open, go ahead and get outside and get out of bounds. Eagles do have all three of their timeouts remaining as well as Murray set the throw. Now with the pressure coming, Murray can run but chooses to throw downfield, and the catch is made. Kerry Hall again dragging across the middle, and now Allen trying to strike deep with 17 seconds to go in the half. That pass works for 30 yards.
But it's just beautiful touch on that pass while he's running to his right. Dumps it right over the top, and Kerry Hall comes up with another big play for the Eagles.
Now at the 32, and another pass outside, this time to Butler. And inside the 20, Allen is in field goal range, and a timeout called with 8 seconds to go in the half.
You see Tom Westerberg, he was on a full sprint trying to get down to where the play was made by Cody Butler so he could get to the side judge in time to preserve as much time calling the timeout there.
Well, there is time for Allen to run a play as long as it doesn't take too long to develop. If you don't get a touchdown out of it, you can always kick the field goal. They are in Sario Williams' field goal range now.
When you think about the two-time defending state champ, and you talk about the winning streak that they're on and all of these things combined, it doesn't seem like there's ever a spot on the field where they're not comfortable. I mean, they just have the confidence, and that really is bred from Coach Westerberg down to offensive coordinators, defensive coordinators. Just have that calm about them, and they can execute and do what they need to do given any possession.
8 seconds to go here in the first half. Allen with a 14-10 lead, and they have moved the ball very, very quickly.
8 seconds. This is what the rodeo guys go for, isn't it?
Yeah.
Can you hang on for 8 seconds?
Well, That's what Cy Ranch is trying to do here. Now Allen. Here's Murray taking a lot of time, but into the end zone for a touchdown, Kerry Hall. That took all of 7 seconds. And Hall with his sixth touchdown catch of the year.
This drive started with 33 ticks on the clock. And in short order, the Allen Eagles and Kerry Hall especially came up with two huge catches on that drive.
Kick is good. What those of you who have not seen Allen play this year, or maybe even the last two or three years, this is what they do. This is why this team has won 42 in a row. This is why Kyler Murray was the 6A player of the year in Texas and the National High School Player of the Year. So cool and so collected, and they really don't worry about much. Figure they, you know, they have 51 play scoring drives this year. That's astounding to consider.
50.
Yeah.
One play scoring drive.
Yeah.
So
33 seconds is plenty of time.
It's an eternity. But you think about it like this too, Craig. On those one play scoring drives, we're not talking about from the 1 yard line or the 7 or the 8 yard line.
No.
It's from anywhere on the field.
Absolutely.
Anywhere on the field.
66 yards and 4 plays. The Eagles now with their largest lead of the ballgame, up 11. So they'll carry the lead into the locker room at halftime. Kyler Murray just doing the things that he has done over the past 3 seasons. It was interesting to hear him talk about this after the come-from-behind win over Skyline. As Shea mentioned, they trailed 28-10 early third quarter. They were down 17 with a couple of minutes to go in the third quarter, 34-17. And then scored 35 points.
Explosion. Offensive explosion.
In the final 14 minutes of the football game. But to hear Kyler Murray talk about it after the game, he said, "We didn't have a lot of energy on the sideline. Guys were kind of looking around, going, what's going on?" And so he kind of felt, you know, the need to say something to light a spark under him, and they found that spark. First half will end on that squib kick. And the Eagles, led by Kyler Murray, will take a 21-10 lead into the locker room at halftime. Search of that third consecutive state championship. Cy Ranch, a very game effort in the first half to hang with Allen, but that late first half drive was vintage Allen. We check in with our head coach Tom Westberg with our Aaron Hartigan.
Coach, from the outside looking in before that last score, this game a little more tight than most expected. What's your message at the break?
Well, we're just going to go in the locker room and readjust. We've been in some tight battles this last 4 weeks, and so it's no different. This might be the first time we've had the lead at half in a while, so I think our kids are going to regroup and play an awesome second half.
Awesome. Well, best of luck, Coach. Get in there. Hey, now, if you have yet to witness the largest high school band in the country, Allen's Escadrille is coming up here on Fox Sports Southwest. Stick around.
Another call, Santa.
Texans Countdown Live, Sunday on Fox Sports Southwest.
And near the start of the second half, Allen with a 21-10 lead on Cy Ranch. Greg Way and Shea Walker with you back upstairs. And Shea, this thing started with Allen jumping right out of the gate. 52 seconds was all it took for the Eagles to score on a 51-yard touchdown pass to cap the opening drive.
Well, it was an impressive opening drive. And you see the pass play down here to Cody Butler. Kyler Murray lays it in there beautifully for the 51-yard score.
Back
then,
from the
Bush coming back from the Cy Ranch Mustangs, Charlie Booker. It's the big scrum, as you called it. It gets pushed into the end zone. A very nice job again by the Allen running back, Keon Williams. That was after a very long drive, and then it didn't take very long for this one to happen to find Kerry Hall for the touchdown right in between the Cy Ranch defenders.
That was after that field goal by Cy Ranch. They pulled within four, and it took Allen all of 32 out of the remaining 33 seconds on the clock to get a little separation from the Mustangs. The Ford first half stats here And Cy Ranch able to run the ball to the tune of 100 yards and throw the ball a little bit, but Allen doing enough to keep them at arm's length despite having the football only 7.5 minutes of the first half.
Well, going back to that first scoring drive by Allen, it was confusion for the Cy Ranch defense. Take a look. There's a lot of guys in the box here. As we take another look, look inside the box there, and you can see where Kyler Murray is working with Cody Butler. They're on the same page, and the offensive front doing a great job giving Murray time, and he drops the ball in beautifully right over the top of the defender, and Cody Butler with the fantastic catch waltzes into the end zone.
Well, Cy Ranch.
Coach, two costly fumbles in the first half. How does your offense regroup and approach the second half?
Well, we just got to come back and take care of the ball, and, you know, you mentioned that. On this playoff run, we have not been turning the ball over, and, you know, they're too good offensively for us to waste possessions, and those were critical.
I know your defense wasn't happy about giving up that touchdown right before the half. What did you say to your guys?
Oh, well, you know, he's a great player, and he's going to make some plays. We didn't get any pressure on him, and we're going to bring three and not get to him. He's going to make those sorts of plays. So we may have to bring a little more pressure and try to make him uncomfortable.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Greg, back to you.
Well, one positive for Cy Ranch is they get the football to start the second half. We've done several games during this weekend, Shea Walker, where the team scored to take or extend the lead in the locker room, and then they were getting the football to start the second half. Not so here.
Well, and this is a, you have to feel right now at this game, and even though you've got two quarters left, but an 11-point deficit, you've got to get points on this drive. I mean, you just have to get points on this drive for Cy Ranch.
Well, a returnable kick, a couple of yards deep, bringing it out is Bruno. But Bruno,
not a good decision.
Had to field it over the shoulder, and Eagles with excellent coverage. It's all the way back at the 11-yard line. Cy Ranch starting from a hole here.
And we've seen the linebacking core, Misi Tupou and Jacob Yondell, Dallas George, those guys making big plays after that first drive or two where Charlie Booker and Colin Rock were kind of running up and getting in the middle of that field, that they're in, that in the middle of the defense.
It's
gotten a little bit more stingier
from the 11-yard line, and Rock takes off across the 15 to the 16. Jalen Jones, the Allen safety, sold out to go after Charlie Booker, and Rock kept the football. Taylor wrapped him up, but an excellent run on first down, at least to get out of trouble.
And there was a lot of grass there in front of Colin Rock, but Anthony Taylor, as you said, Craig, closes down, and that play looked like it could have gone for maybe 8 or 9 yards, and it ends up only going for 5.
So second down. Will hand it off, squirting inside and upfield. Enough to pick up the first down is Joseph Johnson.
Yeah, nice slicing run right there by Johnson.
Gain of 9 yards and a first down for Cy Ranch. And the Mustangs sticking with the game plan. And the time to go, not to certainly abandon the run. They wouldn't do it anyway because this is what they do better. The toss outside to Thomas. Cuts it inside, but only able to gain a couple. Jalen Jones, the stop for the Eagles.
Now, moving the chains right now are paramount for the Mustangs. Nice job right there by Colin Rock. The patience that he has, and we've seen the decision making on the little dump off passes and screen plays, and he's executed very well. But holding on to that ball to the very last second before he kicks it out to Chandler Thomas is. Keeps Thomas from losing yards, and he ends up picking up about 1, 1.5.
Second down and 9. Booker, however, spilled just across the line of scrimmage. Jalen Ellis, the tackle for Allen, and it's going to bring up 3rd down and 8 for Cy Ranch. It's more the Eagle defense looking now for Charlie Booker on a lot of those carries.
Well, they're getting there and clogging up the running lanes that were open in the first quarter.
It's an important early moment of this second half. The Cy Ranch down 11, 3rd down and 8 from the 26. Rock with a blocker to set it for him, and is able to go downfield. The target being R.J. Sneed with a catch and a first down out over the 35 to the 37-yard line, a gain of 11.
A fantastic route by Sneed. You saw the coverage was not all that bad as Colin Rock rolls out to the right, throws a dart, and Sneed comes up with a nice grab.
Cyranch moving the ball here on this first possession. Call it a 12-yard catch and run to the 38. That's more back to the ground, and that's Booker. Only for one to the 39. Jacob Yandell, the tackle for the Eagles. Second down and 9 for Cyranch coming up. So Yandell on the stop, and it's second down. And the forward progress will get it near the 40-yard line.
Well, the linebackers for Allen getting much more aggressive, closing down and playing really a lot closer to the line of scrimmage than they were earlier in this game.
Just shy of the Allen of the Cyranch 40-yard line. Rock with some pressure coming to release the football. And a first down across midfield. Sliding across is Dylan Prosky. That goes for 12 yards and a first down for Cyranch.
Dallas Georgia linebacker, talk about those backers playing closer to the line of scrimmage. Taking a look as he runs up on the run fake. And Prosky gets outside and comes up with a nice play for the Mustangs.
At the Eagle 48-yard line. Cyranch, first drive of the second half. The Mustangs moving the ball. Back to Booker. This time swarmed over and dropped for a loss. Yandell and Dallas George on the team up tackle. That will lose yardage for Cyranch.
See the linebacker George getting down to the legs of Booker, making sure that he is not going to make any forward progress. In fact, loses a couple of yards on that play. The linebackers again creasing down, and that's crazy. You know, it's kind of that thing where you, if you guess right, you're in the right spot. Dallas George read the keys, and he was right.
Second down at 13. And the pass dumped over the middle, but Booker trying to escape, can't do it. That'll lose another yard. EC Tupo sniffing it out, and that brings up third down at 14.
Saw the rush coming in from Sione Tupo. And BC on the back end cleans it up very nicely for the Eagles. Now third down, 14 to go.
Booker has been stymied. Touched the ball that last one, dumped off to him, but he also only has 4 yards rushing in his last 8 attempts. Now third down and 14 from the Cyranch 48. Under pressure, Rock escaping it for the moment, and now the run. Outside, but not nearly enough for the first down. However, a flag comes in, and it might have been a face mask as BC Tupo was wrapping it up. Also, Sione Tupo still down on the field.
It looks like that's where the flag was thrown, whereas Sione Tupo was.
Personal foul, face mask, Allen number 31, 15-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
BC Tupo.
In a hustle play. I mean, it's not an intention. He's just doing his very best to get to the scrambling Colin Rock. You see, Rock's got a little bit of his face mask on the stiff arm, but. Yeah, right there, and he was going to be well short of the first down, but now, with that mark off, Cyranch Mustangs down to the 38-yard line of Allen.
Keeping the drive alive. First and 10 from Eagle 33.
Check that, 33-yard line.
Booker. And again, the defense. Eagles are looking for him, and Wasserike met him at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Booker had a big first half. Clearly among the adjustments that the Eagles were making at halftime, Shea, was to look out for number 21.
Well, and really the defensive line is really working now, Craig, on penetration and disrupting the pulling guards and tackles and making sure just clogging up and mucking up the works there. It makes it very difficult for Charlie Booker to get any running room.
Second down and 10 for the 33. Booker will stay with the run, but Allen will stay with the pursuit. This will lose 2 yards back from the 35. Jacob Yandell leading the charge. Yandell coming in for it. And Jay, that offensive line that had such a great push in the first half for Cy Ranch, is getting pushed back now here in the third quarter.
And that Allen Eagle defense, Craig, as you said, the pushback. But it's not just the pushback and, like, with reckless abandon. They're pushing back and holding their ground. So they're getting penetration and hanging in and just forming a wall there where the linebackers can come in and clean up. Doing a really nice job of bottling up the run game now for the Mustangs.
Third down at 12 for Cy Ranch at the Allen 35. Eagles have had the ball the entire third quarter, but the drives have been stymied, and they don't get this playoff in time. It's going to be a delay of game. This play will not count. The clock hit zero, and that'll cost Cy Ranch five more.
Before the snap, delay of game. Cypress Ranch number 7, 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Saw the anguish there from Gene Johnson.
Yeah, that's a very unfortunate and untimely penalty.
One thing that Brad McCoy pointed out yesterday on our telecast before a game is that as a quarterback, if it's your first time playing in the stadium, one of the things you have to do is locate the play clock. You have to do it, and Coach Johnson wanting him to go ahead and get the ball snapped. It's the first penalty here for 5 yards for Cy Ranch, but it's a costly one. It's now third down and 17. And the snap gets rolled out. Ball still loose on the turf. Allen has it. Dylan Stone recovers the fumble. Colin Rock trying to pick it up. And when he did, he lost control of it. And Allen takes over.
He was not able to field it cleanly, not only after the snap, but as it goes down. And part of the reason is because Sione Tupou was right on his back. So as Colin Rock was, felt like he had an opportunity to go down and get on top of the ball, number 5 comes in and makes sure that he doesn't. Great hustle by the defensive end.
And then the recovery to Dylan Stone, the senior defensive tackle. So Allen's first possession of the second half comes with 4 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. And now with an 11-point lead for the offense stop. Right here goes Murray with running room. Kyler Murray outside. The sidelines and a step out of bounds, but a great first down run takes it for 30 yards to the Cy Ranch 12.
Well, the extra speed in the burst once he goes down the middle of the field toward the sideline, you saw him kind of check it down and shut it down to try to maintain his balance and stay in bounds. He'll shut it down just a little bit right there as he's trying to get it on the sideline, but an outstanding scramble run there by Kyler Murray.
At the Mustang 12, Murray. So the end zone is just off the hands of Cody Butler. Butler with a step on Kenzie Lopez, but it's incomplete.
Now the accuracy that Kyler Murray throws the ball with is just really impressive, and we have been able to see him progress over his career here at Allen, and certainly with them playing in the state championship game now for the third consecutive time. It's pretty impressive to see the accuracy of the arm strength.
Second attempt from the 12. Keon Williams around the corner. Williams, however, bulldog down at the 9-yard line. Christian Cobalt did a good job to hold on to him and limit it to a 4-yard pickup to the 8.
Well, Cobalt had to fight off the block. You see from the wide receiver up here at the top. Goes in and makes sure that he secures the running back where he cannot advance the ball.
Third down and 6. Murray to the end zone. And short.
It'd be enough for a first down, it looks like, though. It'll be first and goal as the ball was stretched out just beyond the marker.
Camden Harrison, the junior wide receiver, his 6th catch of the season. Another receiving target for Kyler Murray. It moves the chains, and it's first and goal, Allen, at the Cy Ranch 1-yard line. Eagles looking for a commanding lead now here in the third quarter. Murray across the middle, easy pickings. Kerry Hall, his 2nd touchdown catch of the night.
Well, what a game Kerry Hall is having. 5'7", 155-pound junior Five touchdowns on the season coming in. And man, he is having an outstanding game.
Allen certainly feeling it now with some momentum. This is something the fans certainly should be a lot more pleased with than some of the airtight dramatics they've had in recent weeks, as the kick is good. And it's an 18-point Allen Eagle lead. Kyler Murray, his third touchdown pass. And now a special message from Dairy Queen.
I'm here with Gene.
This state championship weekend, it began Thursday morning with the smallest classification, 2A Division II. The Remont Tigers faced a 14-point deficit heading into the fourth quarter, and then sophomore Rashad Ball took over, 35-yard touchdown run, then a 23-yard run. Remont outscored Albany 21-0 in the final quarter to win the 2A Division II state championship, 28-21. 10 state championship games in a span of about 60 hours. Pretty cool stuff.
And it's been fun.
Absolutely.
And how about the games? Well, we have seen some fantastic contests. The Gilmer West Orange Star game. That was a barn burner. I mean, we've seen barn burners almost every game.
That set the tone for fabulous finishes on Friday as Gilmer rallied from a 25-7 halftime deficit to win 35-25. Then the 4A Division II championship. Number one Navasota beating number two Argyle in double overtime. Then, of course, Guinness with a touchdown with 21 seconds to go to beat Cedar Park last night, 38-35 in the 5A Division II title. Now on the kickoff return, here goes Chandler Thomas. Thomas, however, upended. Nice job by Sawyer Williams, the kicker, to save it from going the distance.
Well, the last line of defense, and Saul Williams, as you said, Craig, a very nice job of making sure Chandler Thomas does not take that one to the house. However, it will be outstanding field position. And Cy Ranch, and we talked about in their first possession that they needed to score, but they did not. Of course, the Allen Eagles turn right around and do score, so it's important now. I think you've got to feel like every possession, you've got to get it into the end zone.
First down, Rock keeping ahead across midfield. DC Tupo, the tackle. Cyranch had moved the ball down to the Allen 33 on that last drive, Shea, to open the third quarter. The penalties and then the turnovers ultimately took Cyranch's scoring chance away. And then Allen capitalized, as they so often do, very, very quickly. Second down, Joseph Johnson. Second and five, Johnson on the carry.
The defense doing a very nice job right there of making Johnson bounce it out wide and not allowing him to go north and south. And that's again, it's just the guys getting in the interior, just log jamming everything and blocking the path. And Johnson, as he was running toward the boundary, he may have picked up 2 or 3 yards on the carry, but wasn't easy. A lot of blue jerseys around him.
No doubt about that. Third and three for the Mustangs. To Booker. And this time Booker gets loose. A first down. Looked like one of the first half runs for Charlie
yes.
Booker. Jalen Jones with a tackle, but Booker will go for 9 and a first down.
Well, and Jalen Jones has been an outstanding safety for this Eagles defense. Second on the team in total tackles. A nice job right there bringing Booker down in the open field.
First and 10 at the 35 of Allen. So back-to-back drives in this third quarter. Cyranch has moved it inside Allen 35-yard line. Only for a yard this time to the 34. Carry. Burleson, the tackle. Second down. That carry by Broski.
Yeah, Brett Burleson in there doing yeoman-like work, fighting off the blockers and passing the offensive lineman down to the second level while he stays locked in on the running backs.
Now a minute to play in the third quarter. Second second down and nine. Booker with running room this time. And Booker inside the 20 and a first down.
Nice vision there by Charlie Booker. Cuts back to the left. Sees a nice alley and he turns it left in and goes back right toward the middle of the field. Important first down as well.
Under a minute to play third quarter. Cyranch trailing by 18 points. Back to Charlie Booker. Outside, and here goes Booker to the end zone and in. Charlie Booker giving hope to the Mustang fans here late in the third quarter.
Well, and he got an outstanding block by his wide receiver, Cameron Greer, number 11. Just absolutely stoned the defender. And Charlie Booker cuts it back up inside of that, walks into the end zone.
Trying to pull within 11 points now. The conversion, however, blocked. And picking up is Dallas George. Here's George, who can take this all the way back for a defensive two-point conversion.
Tom Westerberg gives that the seal of approval.
So instead of being an 11-point game, it is now a 14-point game. Dallas George with the block, the pickup, and the return to extend the Allen lead to a 14-point margin. Charlie Booker brought Cyranch back with a score, but the extra point was blocked. Return for two by Dallas George, and Allen leads by 14. Booker did his job. Booker tonight has carried the mail for Cyranch. 23 carries, 115 yards, and he finished the scoring drive with a 19-yard run. Unfortunately for the Mustangs, they net only 4 points out of all of this because Dallas George blocked the extra point and returned it the length of the field for a defensive two-pointer, and it's a two-touchdown lead for the Eagles. So it's 30-16.
You left your feet.
Jones to field it for 7. Popped hard the 15-yard line. Cyranch not giving up. Down 2 touchdowns here in the waning seconds of the third quarter. Great stringer is the man who went headlong right into Jalen Jones.
Nice coverage downfield. Looks like Jones may have had something as he tries to cut it back. He gets threaded there by Braden Stringer.
Kyler Murray back to work from the 16-yard line of Allen. To the ground of David Feliciano, but he's net dropped for a loss on the final play of the third quarter. Allen pushed the margin out to 18 in the third quarter. And then Cyranch drove back for a touchdown. The results, he blocked extra point attempt. Return for two gives Allen a 14-point lead heading into the final quarter of high school football in 2014. Another great high school football championship of Texas. Greg Way, Shea Walker, Brooke Bentley, Aaron Hartigan, and our Fox Sports Southwest State Championship broadcast team. A team of Allen in search of its 43rd consecutive win and helped out by some mistakes by Cyranch tonight.
Well, it really did, and it's very uncharacteristic, as you heard Gene Johnson saying, is that We haven't fumbled or turned the ball over hardly at all through our playoff run. And now we've got three of the turnovers, and one of them very costly, as it was a touchdown run that did not happen. And then Dallas George blocking the extra point after that last touchdown by Charlie Booker. He takes it all the way back for the two-point conversion.
Allen with a football on second down and 11 as this fourth quarter gets underway. From the Eagle 15, Murray slicing it over the middle to Cody Butler for a first down.
Well, Cody Butler is the wide receiver furthest away from Kyler Murray, and the offensive front doing a very nice job of protecting Murray. It's a great pocket. Stands in there, and he delivers another strike downfield.
18 yards on the pass to Cody Butler. Murray to the air, and another catch by Butler. What a grab by the senior receiver. He's having a tremendous night tonight. Butler with a grab and another first down.
Well, when you know where you're going as the wide receiver and the quarterback has time to deliver the ball like Kyler Murray does, and you have the arm strength of Kyler Murray, it's a fantastic play.
Murray trying to run this time, and he'll be forced out of bounds. Well, Cody Butler, five catches and even 100 yards tonight.
Well, and he started it off with a bang with that 51-yard grab for Allen's first score. Having a heck of a night.
Second down and six for the 47. Murray over the middle. Catch made by Lee Morris.
And here's a frustrating thing from a defensive perspective, is that you feel like, you know, there's not like this big Herculean play. It's just kind of the steady progression of plays that pick up 16, 18 yards.
And here's Murray looking for the Herculean play there. What a catch by Kerry Hall, sliding over the middle. Hall with a catch, another move of the chains, and a first down. Butler and Hall, more so than Jalen Guyton, have been the big targets for Kyler Murray tonight.
Well, they have, and Guyton, as you said, the go-to guy. However, these other guys stepping up, and Murray working down the food chain, if you will, and just finding whoever's open, and that's exactly what you want to do as a quarterback.
Going back to the air again to Lee Morris. By the way, Kerry Hall, eight catches for 92 yards and two touchdowns. 4 yard pickup on the pass to Morris, and it's second down and six. Ball was at the Cy-Ranch 20. Keon Williams is in the backfield. But Murray has been on a hot streak. He throws again. High and incomplete. That one off the hands of Butler. And it's now third down and six.
And Cody Butler is a good-looking receiver. 6'1", 175 pounds. Not able to bring that one in. Just off the hands.
And before that incompletion, Shea, Kyler Murray had hit seven straight passes. Third down and six. He'll look to run this time, but it's struck out. There's also a flag down. Murray goes down at the 19-yard line. Great Stringer. Justin Rabelais, the tackle. This is going to go against Allen. Wayne Elliott, tell us, holding is the call against the Eagles.
It's been a pretty clean game by the Eagles so far. His holding penalty notwithstanding, but an offensive line doing a really nice job of keeping the pocket protected there for Murray.
Wayne Elliott's having a conversation with Gene Johnson. I think they're discussing the spot
holding
of the foul.
Out on number 50. That penalty's declined. Fourth down.
And that's why. Exactly. And that's why. Because it gets to fourth down at this point, and they wanted to see exactly where the spot of the foul was. And it wasn't worth it to him to do that, to take the penalty and give Kyler Murray another shot. Nope. Instead, it's fourth and five, and the Eagles look to settle for three.
This nice job of patience there by Gene Johnson and making sure that he had the right information to make the call to decline that penalty.
Sawyer Williams can, however, make it a three-score game again, and he does from 36 yards away. Sawyer Williams with a field goal to make it 33-16. Tom Westerberg in search of his fourth state championship, third in a row. The first one came 6 years ago at what is now known as NRG Stadium in Houston, taking on the Hurricanes, a four-man high tower, and the Hurricanes were right at home in Houston. Darius Johnson, 41 yards for this touchdown. That was the opening score of the ball game. But the Eagles, undaunted, backup quarterback Tucker Carter filling in for the injured Matt Brown. Found Jeremiah Williams on the throwback score, tying the game at 7 in the third quarter. Carter to Justin Robinson, 9 yards in for the score. Eagles up 21-7, 5 minutes to play. And Allen's rise to the top, complete their first ever state championship. And our Aaron Hartigan on the sidelines with a member of that 2008 5A Division I state championship team.
Now Texas A&M offensive tackle and projected to go pretty highly in this year's draft as well. Cedric Oboihe. We were just showing highlights of that 08 state championship game, the very first for Allen. Where does that moment maybe rank in your sports career?
To this day, it's still very special to me. I mean, like you see me, Nate, Jeremy, we all bonded through that moment. And, I mean, it's one of the top moments of my life, even today.
You got to look at this Allen group and what they're doing and have some sort of pride knowing you were the group that started it all. What sort of pride maybe comes with that?
Yeah, I mean, we were the original. That's what we call it. And it's a great honor. But, I mean, this team right now, Kyler, what he's doing is very special.
Yeah, how do you put into words what they're not only doing tonight, but what they've done the last 3 years?
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, it's unheard of. Makes me very proud. And all the alumni makes us very proud. So it's very special what they're doing right now.
Now we want to know what you're telling Kyler to keep him committed to A&M.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's coming. He's coming, yeah.
Well, we wish you the best of luck moving forward in your career, Sed, and appreciate you taking the time. Enjoy the rest of the game. Craig Shea.
All right, Aaron, thanks. Cedric, of course, another teammate off of that Allen team, and a teammate is at Texas A&M, Zoma Wachiku.
Yeah, that's right. Easy Wachiku, I think, is still on the Houston Texans practice squad, I believe. First another outstanding wide receiver.
From the 23-yard line. Cy Ranch, a fair catch on that popped-up kickoff. Now really needing to throw the ball downfield in a hurry, and Colin Rock's pass for Cullen Botsinger incomplete. Allen going for 43 in a row. They won 42 consecutive games. And you take a look at the longest win streaks for 11-man football. Salina at the top of that list during their run of four in a row and into the 2002 season. Abilene High's Warbirds, Chuck Mosier, won 49 in a row with three consecutive state titles and nearly a fourth.
Now, Greg,
54 through 57.
You're going to know this, and I'm going to test your knowledge just a bit, but the Salina Bobcats on that run, did they do that with one coach?
G.A. Moore.
G.A. Moore.
The all-time winningest coach in the game. We also had state championships at Pilot Point as well as Salina. South Lake Carroll, the great run, winning 49 in a row under Todd Dodge, your old teammate. 0-4-0-7. Lake Travis, the only school to win five in a row, and did that under three different head coaches. Third down and 10 for Cy Ranch. Heaved downfield and incomplete, and it'll bring up fourth down for the Mustangs.
You can tell, obviously, throwing the ball for Colin Rock and this Mustang offense is not what they do. They're better at ground and pound and getting the ball in the middle of the field and just trying to grind it out. But trailing like they are right now, needing to try to get some kind of offense going.
Colin Rock's had it going difficult tonight, completing 6 of 11 for 117 yards. But he's hit some key passes, but unable to do so here. And now, with 9:40 to go in the ball game and down 17 points, Cy Ranch in a punting situation. Miles roll to punt. Good kick. Backpedaling. And the fair catch made right at the 39-yard line by Gary Hall. A punt of 38 yards without a return. So 9:32 to go in this UIL 6A Division I state championship. Final high school football game of the year in Texas. And Allen heading to a third straight state title.
The There's nothing like high school football in Texas. And there's nothing like traveling across the state to see it firsthand.
He's getting it done!
It's the best of the DQ Big Game of the Week. Sunday night on Fox Sports Southwest. Friday high school football isn't over till you want.
The 2014 UIL 6A Division I State Football Championship on Fox Sports Southwest is brought to you by State Farm. Visit texas.statefarm.com to get to a better state. By Ford, the Dream Big Sales event is going on now at your Texas Ford dealer. Ford is the best in Texas. And by DQ, the stop sign for Texas. For the best treat seats and drinks in Texas, stop at DQ. Here in the fourth quarter, the Allen Eagles with a 33-16 lead on the Cy Ranch Mustangs from the Eagle 39-yard line. Keon Williams upfield, breaking tackles, and Williams in the Cy Ranch territory and a first down as Williams continues to keep the legs churning, and he'll take that one for 24 yards.
Not very often you see a guy bounce it out wide again, and then have the Jets to turn it right up the middle and pick up positive yards. Keon Williams did just that.
First down. This time Murray looking to go to the air. Got a man wide open. Downfield. Kerry Hall, his third touchdown of the night. Kerry Hall has been taking what the defense would give him over the middle, finding seams, and he just became a deep threat there.
Well, he's the inside receiver, and what he does, the outside receiver runs a stop route to hold the cornerback. He goes a post corner, and he's wide open going toward the pylon.
Sawyer Williams for the extra point. 40-16 Allen. 9:02 to go. And how about the ball game for the junior wide receiver, Kerry Hall?
Take another look here. He's the inside receiver. You see the post move. That's what holds the safety, but the stop route is what draws the corner back down. And Kerry Hall breaks it back out to the flag. A very easy, nice route that he ran, and Kyler Murray drops it in perfectly. Keep in mind, the protection for Murray, outstanding.
Consider this, Shay. Coming into the night's ball game, Kerry Hall had caught 60 passes, 600 yards this year. He scored 5 touchdowns the entire season.
Yes.
He has scored 3 tonight, 9 catches for 129 yards for Kerry Hall.
It's the unselfishness of guys like Jalen Guyton, where guys like Kerry Hall can step up and have a big game, where guys like Cody Butler can continue to step up and have a big game. And this Allen Eagle team and Coach Tom Westerberg, it is a team. And everybody contributes, and right now, Kerry Hall is having a fantastic night in the state championship game.
Allen, amazing run for Cy Ranch, but running into that Allen stone wall right now, Shay.
When this Eagles offense is going, Craig, I mean, it really, for the last 3 years and all the comebacks that you referenced earlier through the playoffs, well, that ball hit the ground.
It did.
I don't know if the Allen Eagles may have gotten on it.
They did. Allen will have it. And when it rains, it pours. Sawyer Williams' kickoff popped up in the air and recovered by the Eagles. Rodney Moss on the recovery for Allen.
And I want to say that's the 4th turnover now on that recovery. As the ball hits the ground, you expect it to bounce forward. It doesn't. It bounces back. And the Allen Eagle special teams are on the spot for the recovery.
So, Murray and Eagles back to work. Kyler Murray will run this time and knock down after a gain of 7.
Kind of gets that gear where it looks like it's cruise control. And then he starts to slow down a little bit, and then he makes a move and picks up another extra 2 or 3 yards.
Second down and three from the 23. David Feliciano in the backfield. This is a flip back and maybe a throwback. Jalen Guyton, however, is dropped back for a loss. Was set up as, I think, going to be a throwback to Kyler Murray, but he was covered, and Guyton ends up taking the loss of 8 yards. So it's now third down after that loss.
And on that play, Craig, you're right. It looked like Jalen Guyton was trying to throw it back across to Kyler Murray.
Third down and 11. Murray well covered. So now he goes back to doing what he does best. Throwing the ball over the middle. A catch and a touchdown. Lee Morris. This is what Allen does. They score points by the wheelbarrow. They score them very quickly. They did it last week, as we mentioned, 35 points in a 14-minute span. And now they've blown it open.
Well, Lee Morris doing a nice job dragging across the coverage. There were a couple of defenders there for Cy Ranch. As Morris made the catch, he got hit. But he just kind of bounced him out to the outside. He gets to the sideline, cuts it up. He only needs to make about 4 or 5 more yards to get into the end zone, and he's able to do that. Right here on your screen. If he's going to take that shot, leaving right down this way as he gets hit, it moves him out to the outside, and he just walks in for the touchdown. Nice job of going up and grabbing the ball.
Well, that's 17 quick points for Allen here in the fourth quarter, including 2 touchdowns in 73 seconds. Speaking of quick scores, it happened in the 2A Division I state championship back on Thursday afternoon. Number 3 in the state, Canadian. Number 5 in the state, Mason. The punchers with the early score, and then an interception coming in for the Wildcats, and Canadian went to work after the Braden Gallup pass. Chance Cook sailing in for a touchdown and then taking this end around to the house. Canadian pulling away in the second half. They win it 34-7 over Mason, Canadian's first state title since 2008. So congratulations to the Wildcats. Winning the 2A Division I crown. Those were Thursday morning and afternoon. Remond winning the 2A Division II title. Canadian winning 2A Division I. Pop-up kick. Again, and a fair catch called for by Dwight Benn. 7:49 to go, and at this point, certainly Allen cruising an incomplete control, but the coaching staff and Gene Johnson gathering around his guys, and I think the message here is play for some pride down the stretch. You got Absolutely. 8 minutes of football left. Don't worry about the score. Go out and play and try to
just
show
make
some
plays and do what we do and do what we did to get us here.
You heard Dr. Charles Bright mention it at halftime, 52,308 on hand. It's the second largest attendance in UIL State High School Football Championship history, second only to last year's Allen Pearland Championship game, over 54,000 in attendance a year ago on that Saturday evening. Brett Burleson moves upfield. And considering that there were 40,000 for the afternoon and then 46,000 for the 6A Division II titles, Dr. Brightup said it's a standalone attendance. And folks wonder about the overlap from one to the other. But this one stands alone.
It's just, again, a fantastic culmination of this entire weekend and 3 days, 10 state champions. It's just fantastic and to be around and to see. You know, Craig, for you and I, we got to open this on Thursday morning at the 10 o'clock kick. Albany-Bremond game that we highlighted just a few minutes ago. And running all the way through to today or to this game, culmination of events. And we say this every year, but man, what a fantastic ride and what a great job by everybody involved.
Absolutely. And I also, it's third down at 5 coming up here for Cy Ranch. Want to throw a special shout out to our good friend and producer, the good doctor, Dr. Robert Steinfeld,
yes,
who was originally tabbed to be a major part of the championship productions. And the good doctor
is at
underwent triple bypass surgery yesterday, came through at 5, Rumor was is that he had his production notes ready for the medical team. The proverbial Steiny pack.
There you go.
Had that ready for the surgeon and the attending surgeon, supposedly the anesthesiologist. They wanted all of that. And then
someone from admissions checked with him, though, and they wanted to see their pack as well. And I'm sure that they got one.
First and 10 of the 45 and a carry for Chandler Thomas. We joke about it, but we're very, very, very relieved and thrilled that the good doctors come through that procedure. And we look forward to seeing Bob Steinfeld back at what he does so well. And I might add, what a great job Dave Keeney and Mike Uguccione have done in helping with the teams to fill the void. Everybody. What so many other people involved in all of it on the scramble upfield by Colin Rock. The production crews throughout the course of the weekend, the staff has been nothing short of amazing. I was mentioning, of course, with our fearless leader, John Heidke of Fox Sports Southwest, as we were looking at all of this. 20 years ago, we were talking about how great it would be to have all the state championships in one site. And even then, I don't think either John or I envisioned what this has become.
I don't know how you could have, because it's such an outstanding venue. Colin Rock.
What a great run by Rock. And inside the 20-yard line for the junior quarterback. So Rock and the Mustangs still fighting here late in the ballgame. Rock able to turn the corner, get away from and tightrope the sidelines as well to take it down to the Allen 17. On an option this time, the toss hits the turf. However, so picked up, it'll lose 3 yards on the play, and it was a fortuitous hop to Joseph Johnson. It'll be second down and 13. Second down and 13 from the 20. Second down and 13 from the 20. Rock with some time and a receiver and dropped.
Tight end Solbeck got behind the defenders, not able to secure the ball as he was going into the end zone.
You see the frustration on his face. He knew he had what would have been a touchdown catch.
Well, there were 3 ticks on the play clock when that went off, and Colin Rock, I think, had made a couple of adjustments and calls at the line of scrimmage. You said it earlier, Craig, when it rains, it pours.
Third down and 13. Versailles Ranch. Trouble for Rock. Get rid of the football and knocked away. Breaking on the ball is Tyler Fleming, senior corner, intended for Cullen Botsinger. And it brings up fourth down.
As we look forward for the Allen Eagles, Kyler Murray, obviously a senior. Jalen Guyton as well. When we talked about the defense, and that may be being the difference this year. And Coach Tom Westerberg told us, he said, look, we're a good high school defense. We used to be a great high school defense when we had different players. But we've hung in there, we've battled. And if you look at it, there are only 2 seniors that start on this defensive side of the ball for the Allen Eagles. So that bodes well for them in the coming years.
Yeah, the question will be next year, hey, who replaces Kyler Murray and who becomes the trigger man of the offense?
Yep.
Because the defense should be really salty. There's the pass on fourth down and 13. It's going to be short of the first down to Johnson. Well, one of the key highlights of this state championship weekend was the middle game yesterday, the 6th game, the 4A Division II state championship. Number 1 and undefeated Navasota. Number 2 and unbeaten Argyle. And key touchdown pass. A key pass coming to Trendavian Dixon, and then Shelton Epler with the score, and then Dixon for the touchdown in overtime. Argyle one last chance on fourth down, unable to convert. And the Rattlers hang on for their second state title in the last 3 years, the double overtime thriller. The win over Argyle. As you look at all the state championship results, congratulations to the Wascom Wildcats winning their first ever state title at 3A Division II crown, as Keon Williams on the carry for Allen. The 3A Division I championship, just like Allen's doing, Cameron Yeo with a three-peat. Beat Mineola 70-40, a very impressive win for Rick Rhodes and the Yeoman. And then Gilmer with the biggest comeback of the weekend, down 25-7 into the third, into the first half, and a comeback to win 35-25.
Kyler Murray getting a curtain call here. Well deserved.
Kyler Murray's career at its conclusion.
Well, what a high school career. 3 years, undefeated record as a starter.
He'll go 43-0 as Keon Williams. Run upfield. Murray wind up passing for more than 4,500 yards this year. 53 touchdowns.
Now the entire offense for the Allen Eagles. Coming off the field and letting a couple of guys get some snaps.
At the 28. Jared Harvey, the sophomore, in at quarterback. Hand off to Brandon Ruppman. And here's Ruppman down the sidelines. That's actually Trent Clark on the duplicate number there. Trent Clark on the run. He'll take it downfield. A big run downfield for Clark. There's a flag down as well.
Personal foul, face mask, Allen, number 24. 15-yard penalty. Still be first down.
And that was on the run downfield by Clark.
You don't see that very often, but as he was getting chased, he's trying to get away, and he's got a hand on the face mask. He couldn't quite get it off. You see the head of the defender there gets pulled down, so that's a nice call by the officials.
So it'll be moved back to the 43-yard line with 2:46 to go. Allen content to let the clock move here. First and 10 at the 43. Pass. Moving inside is Ryan Mina, the junior receiver.
Mustangs from Cy Ranch had a decent playoff run a couple of years ago. Last year missed the playoffs.
And only their fifth year as a program.
Yeah, this year making it all the way to the state championship game.
Inside 2 minutes to go. Ina was on that last catch. Now a handoff. Some of the younger players, Marlon Ellis, lesser usual reserves, get an opportunity. So Allen is headed for its third consecutive state championship, and you can add that name to that most impressive list. These are consecutive state champions since 1990, when it went to the split division format, the 5A Division I and Division II, and then eventually all classifications in it. Lake Travis, the only five-time winner, Salina with four in a row, and then Lamarck, Midland Lee, South Lake Carroll, Carthage, and Dangerfield from 2008 through 2010, each with a three-peat involved there. Cameron Yeo joins the party this year.
Yeah, as does the Allen Eagles.
That will be the latest member of the Three Timers Club. And Terry Oyeni, a sophomore, on the catch. Inside a minute to go in the game. Smiles going on all around that Allen Eagle sideline.
Well, and it's got to be gratifying as a coach, Craig, to win a different way. And each of these championships for Allen has kind of had that flavor to it. Last year, defensively, again, this Allen team was just absolutely fantastic and could stonewall pretty much any offense, and they did. This year, defensively, they had to outscore a bunch of guys.
Connor Smith, a senior quarterback for Allen, will take the final knee, the snap, and it's complete. The three-peat is complete for the Allen Eagles. 43 in a row for the 6A Division I state football champions of Texas. Tom Westerberg in control, even in the celebration. All right, shake the hands. Here we go. Not only their third in a row, but their fourth in the last 6 years, fourth in the last seven seasons.
Good job, guys. Good job, guys. Good job. Good back. Good job.
Well, Allen, the state champions, and you see Gene Johnson. You see the Cy Ranch Mustangs with some consolation going on. Time for our DQ play of the game, and it happened less than a minute into the football game. Shea Walker setting the tone.
That 51-yard touchdown throw by Tyler Murray to Cody Butler. I don't know if you can have a prettier pass and catch, but led the receiver beautifully. Butler waits to extend the hands at the very last second, and that's exactly how you draw it up. 51 yards, and that got this Allen offense off and running.
You see what Kyler Murray says, Texas tested, and they all have been tested. They've had the target on their back and survived it through a very difficult, I would say the most difficult route to get to the state title, and then to win it. And the architect, Tom Westerberg, on the field with our Aaron Hartigan.
Coach, you said coming into this game, it was about having fun.
Yeah.
How fun is three straight Texas's highest classification?
Three's awesome. And to send those seniors out like that and to send Kyler out, what a special player, what a special kid. And you know, I hope everybody enjoyed his career here. I know we did, and he's just a special player.
How do you put into words what he's done not only for the program, not only for Allen, but for high school football?
Well, when you come play here and they open up the upper deck and you have all the people we have, you know, everybody wants to come see it. It's a special day today to see the three games, and Cedar Hill winning theirs and us winning ours again. We're for a DFW sweep in the 6A. It's pretty special.
You guys won 43 straight games in this three-peat here. And you mentioned that each title kind of represents something different. What does this one mean to you, Tom?
Well, this one means a whole lot. I mean, for every kid out there, and you know, it's pretty special to them how hard they worked. They wanted better the team before them, and the road that we fought to get here was tough. And so hopefully everybody out there watched it, enjoyed it as much as we did.
We very much enjoyed it, Tom. Now you go celebrate with those boys. Congratulations.
All right, I think I will. Thank you.
Appreciate it, Coach. Speaking of Kyler Murray, he's standing by with Brooke.
That's right, Aaron. Kyler, your third straight title. How does this top off everything you've done in your career?
Oh, it's icing on top of the cake, you know what I'm saying? Just credit to, you know, all my teammates, you know, everybody I played with in the past, you know, the coaches, the fans, everybody, you know, this is for them. And, you know, I just try to, every time I touch the field, I just try to play my game. You know, hopefully it turns out good. And, you know, it's been a great 3 years.
Over 300 passing yards, five touchdowns. How did things open up for you?
Came out at the start of the game. I was kind of disappointed in myself. You know, offense wasn't clicking as well. But I knew when we came out halftime, you know, I wanted to put on a show for people. You know, they were here to watch us. So, I mean, for me, it was just come out and put on a show.
43-0 as a starter, what pride do you take in everything that this program has accomplished under your watch?
You know, I don't like to take credit for everything. You know, it's not just me. You know, there's a lot of guys that put in work for this. You know, a lot of guys that before us that put in work for us, the coaches. You know, it's just a lot of hard work and dedication, and you know, like I said, it's been a fun 3 years.
Congratulations. Go enjoy. Craig, back up to you.
Kyler Murray, all season long tested, passing every test. And tonight, Kyler Murray is our Ford player of the game.
Well, just again, spectacular numbers by any measure. You see at the very bottom, 43-0 as a starter. Ran for 63 yards tonight, 5 touchdowns, and you know, just the accuracy, the arm strength that he has is impressive. And we've gotten to see, we have had the opportunity, Craig, to see him in 3 championship games, and he excelled in all 3.
He was tremendous throughout the course of his high school career, and certainly was on display again tonight. The runner-up medals being draped right now for the Cypress Ranch Mustangs. Let's talk about Cy Ranch a moment, because they were definitely the decided underdog coming in. They were the underdog in several other playoff games and went on a great run to reach the state championship round. Of course, it's disappointing not to finish the job, but nevertheless, to get here was an extraordinary accomplishment for a school and a program as youthful as this one is.
Well, and we talked again about that district down in Houston, in Cypress, Houston area, but the 9 teams that reign in that district and the difficulty that it is to come to, like I said, you said this earlier, we were talking about it earlier, they didn't make the playoffs last year. And that's because it's murderer's row every weekend in that Cy Ranch district. And then to get not just there and come out of that, but also to get to this game and having to run through the playoffs that they had. And Colin Rock, I mean, he was fantastic all season long, and he had a great night tonight as well.
It's time now for the offensive and defense's most valuable players, as selected by the media covering the UIL state championships. Let's pick up the announcement.
These student athletes epitomize the spirit of UIL competition and should be recognized accordingly. Please direct your attention to the field for the draping of the UIL medals. Assisting with the draping of the medals is State Farm Agent Mike Harris and State Farm Agent Matt Wills. Let's all congratulate both teams for an outstanding game and season. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Nike is proud to present the Most Valuable Player Awards to both the offense and defensive MVPs of the game. Presenting tonight's awards are the UIL Executive Director, Dr. Charles Brightup, and representative from Nike, Jeff Johnson. At this time, we direct your attention to the center of the field for the presentation of the Defensive Player of the Game trophy. The Defensive Player of the Game for the Conference 6A Division I Football Championship, as selected by the media here today, from Allen High School, number 39, Dallas George.
Dallas George had a great game defensively, and then, of course, the blocked extra point attempt to take it back for 2 and really kind of wrestle away any little bit of remaining momentum Cy Ranch had.
And I would say, Craig, I put right up alongside of that blocked extra point was the strip on the goal line as Chandler Thomas was going into the end zone and to tighten up this game, and George comes up with that strip. Caused the fumble, and Allen recovered. And yes, he had a great game and very deserving of the defensive MVP.
The offensive player of the game in the Conference 6A Division I Football State Championship, as selected by the media here today, from Allen High School, number 1, Kyler Murray.
There it is, Kyler Murray, our Ford player of the game. A great game tonight, a fabulous season, and a truly outstanding high school football career, 43-0, an incomparable number. for Murray, the offensive player of the game.
Well, the difference between him now versus then, and then being 3 years ago as a sophomore, he had the athleticism, he had the moves, he had the elusiveness, but the maturity is what you would expect. And then his ability to locate receivers and find guys and not just have a go-to guy, but use three, four, five, six different receivers.
Well, and I mentioned it early on in the telecast, what a leader he had become in leading this assault on winning 43 in a row. And then how he felt it incumbent upon himself to pick up his guys last week against Skyline in the semifinals. It was truly an amazing performance. And as we mentioned, a truly remarkable performance for Gene Johnson and the Cy Ranch Mustangs reaching the state final.
Well, and doing it in great fashion as well. And Gene Johnson and his squad, they're certainly disappointed right now. And they hung into this game, and they started out doing what they wanted to do, controlling the ball, running the ball. But the two-time defending state champion was set on a three-peat.